Hi everyone. So real quick, something I wanted to share. Yesterday I went to ESMQ. An apostle was teaching about the spirit of Jezebel. And he says that the spirit of Jezebel comes against generals of God, ministries, and nations. So while he's talking about this, the Lord starts showing me. Well, because apostle says that the spirit that came against Cuba, the reason that Cuba is the way it is because of a spirit of Jezebel that came against the nation. So I start thinking, God starts showing me, and I start thinking, and I'm going, and I'm thinking about the spirit, the story of Esther. When the enemy rose up to come against the Jews, the Israelites, the promised children of God, he wanted to wipe out a whole nation. He wanted to wipe out the promised generation of God, the Israelites. And so this woman, Esther, God puts her in the right place so that she can be promoted to being queen. And it's linked up. Why? Because she needed to have an authoritative position on the earthly realm. Because another thing that Apostle said is that the spiritual realm governs the physical realm. So whenever you see something manifest in the physical, it's first established in the spiritual. So God knew that this principality was going to raise up against his people. So he prepared Esther. That's why the Bible says, maybe that's why her uncle Mordecai says, you know, maybe you were destined to be where you are for such a time as this. However, if you don't do it, God is going to raise up another way. But God made sure to put Esther there and gave her a position of authority to come against this principality, which to me is mind-blowing because I love the story of Esther. I have another teaching not too long from this one where I talk about Esther and the two weapons that she used, which were unity and fasting. But to me, to just think about the authoritative position and how she came against a principality, which was the spirit of Jezebel, is crazy. And then another thing is, one of the guests that came to ESMQ is Paula White. And I used to listen to her back in the day a lot. But when Apostle gave her the mic and that woman started praying, I felt in the spirit such an authority over her life. And I said, wow, God, I don't remember ever sensing that authority from her. And the Lord started speaking to me again. And he started showing me, yeah, but now she is in the White House because I have positioned her there, because I have placed her there. Now she carries a greater weight of authority. And I thought, oh my goodness, it makes sense. Again, because whatever's in the spiritual manifests in the natural. And when you have a position established and that everyone knows, it's not that you call yourself a minister. It's not that you call yourself a president. It's not that you call yourself a prophet. It's that it's been ordained, it's recognized, and it's valid. There is a greater weight and authority. That to me, I loved it. So I wanted to share it because I thought this was really cool. So thanks for watching. God bless you and have a nice day.